Through the unmatched heroism of the 1st Infantry Division, Allied forces were able to overpower Axis troops at Jela and Troina. Even the tanks of the mighty Hermann Goering Division were no match for one of the most accomplished American fighting units of World War II. In 37 days of continuous fighting, the Big Red One had taken control of 18 towns and villages. Operation Husky was an unmitigated Allied success as Axis forces were driven from the island and the Mediterranean sea lanes reopened. Italian dictator Benito Mussolini is removed from power and Italy surrenders on September 8, 1943. Churchill and Roosevelt, believing that momentum had shifted to the Allies' side, commit to opening a second front in Europe to aid the besieged Russian army. Involving over 4,000 landing craft and preceded by U.S. and British airborne drops, Operation Overlord is to be the largest amphibious invasion in history. Now under the command of Major General Clarence R. Huebner, the division sails back to the British Isles that October and begins training for what would become one of the most decisive conflicts of the war. In the early morning hours of June 6, 1944, under the umbrella of the English Channel's unpredictable weather, the invasion gets underway. The 1st Infantry Division is tasked with securing a section of the Normandy coast designated as Omaha Beach. But the German army is well prepared, and Rommel himself, looking for retribution for his sound defeat in North Africa, is tasked with the defense of northern France. The definitive turning point in the war is at hand, and Hitler's Fortress Europa will soon taste the full fury of the battle-hardened troops of the Big Red One.
Guys, do this.
This is gonna be no sweat, right, guys? I mean, they probably don't even know we're coming. Just like the lieutenant said.
Oh, yeah, sure. Just like the lieutenant said. Hey, Sarge! Why aren't we in those Higgins boats with the rest of the division?
Because it's our job to make sure those boys get to the beach alive, Private Kelly. I can't believe we're not getting any fire from the beach. Maybe our boys did a better job than we thought. Thank you.
buddy.
Everyone into the lifeboat!
trenches! Now! Find those damn mortar pits and take them out! Suppress that machine gun!
Thank you.
Bandage and brass, boys. There's a supply depot beyond these doors we still need to secure.
Do we have any idea how well guarded this thing is, Sarge?
No idea, Kelly, but Fox's orders are to secure that depot, whatever the resistance.
Same drill as always, eh, Sarge?
Now someone get those goddamn doors open! Thank you. Gentlemen! Just a quick word. I've scraped through some tough fights since I've been in this man's army. I have to say that this one was the worst I've seen. We lost a lot of good men back there on that beach, and that's a damn shame. But by kicking down Hitler's front door, we saved the lives of hundreds more that will follow. You are the best of the best, and I am damn proud to serve with each and every one of you. All right, enough said. Gather up some ammo, get some rest. I have a feeling that we're just getting started.
Surprised to see you back from the hospital so soon, Sarge.
What happened?
Sarge here got real friendly with a kraut mortar round. Too bad it wasn't you, Brooklyn. I could have used a break from your wisecracks.
Hey, I'd take a nice, comfy hospital bed away from you guys anytime. Besides, what lovely nurse could refuse my obvious charm? Heads up, guys.
Okay, form up. Word just came down from regiment. A few minutes ago, our flyboys hammered a German convoy that was headed for Mons. We need to recon the area and make sure they got the job done. As I said, our boys did a number on them, so we can expect very little contact. The brass wants us to take a closer look and mop up any survivors before the dozers can roll in and clear the way. You boys pulled an easy detail for a change. In and out, quick. Back in time for the jump off. Questions? Outstanding, ladies! Mount up! Watch where you're driving, Private. Bad enough the Krauts are trying to kill us.
What the hell are they shooting?
Look out, they're coming in! Shoot them! Where are they?
Patrols from Mons. Keep your eyes open. Keep going, Private. There's nothing we can do here. Stay alert and watch your speed!
I can barely see the road, Sarge!
Slow it down, Castillo.
Poor bastards. Our boys sure did give up.
Ambush! Back up! Get moving!
German armor! It's locked!
Damn it! We lost a Jeep. Give him hell with that 50, Sergeant! Here they come!
Here they come!
Castillo's dead! We gotta get out of here, now!
Come on, Max! Max! He's dead! We have to go! Now! Krauts! Get off the road! Follow me!
That crap machine gun. We're gonna need it.
Here they come!
Thank you.
Brooklyn, cover the door. We're going in. Grab a window and keep your eyes peeled. If there were any crowds in the area, they sure as hell heard what just happened out there. Understand, but yes, sir. Understood. Out.
Stack them like cardboard.
Okay, everyone, listen up. It appears we're not the only ones having a bad day. The Flyboys also missed a couple of idiots on the ridge not far from here. And they're raining hell down on the assault force. The entire regiment is pinned, and there's no way they can get through to us unless we take out those guns.
Wait. The whole regiment is pinned down, and they expect five of us to launch an assault on an entire German division?
Glad you're paying attention, Private. Look, these guys are counting on us, and we can't let them down.
How come everyone's always counting on us, Sarge?
Because we're the infantry, Corporal, and God loves the infantry!
Great. More hedgerows.
Come on. We're almost there. Keep moving.
Whoa, that plane's in trouble. Is that one of us?
Let's get over there and check it out.
Don't look like anyone gonna survive that. Crowd!
Here, keep moving! Somebody get those boards out of the way!
Sounds like we're getting close. Cut through the hedge there.
Get a sector charge on that 88!
What to do. April. Take Smitty and clear that goddamn barn. The rest of you take up defensive positions and provide covering fire. Go!
Park's gonna be okay, right?
Let them do their job, Brooklyn.
Yeah, sure, no sweat. Sarge's gonna be just fine, just like always.
He looks pretty bad. Is he still breathing?
Of course he's still breathing. Sarge here's tougher than anything those lousy crowds could throw at him. He's gonna be just fine, I tell you. Just fine.
That's right, Brooklyn. He's gonna be just fine.
Yeah, don't worry, Sarge. Doc's gonna patch you up real good. We'll see you real soon.